Let's take a look at the varied range of delay sounds that you can create with Echo. Here I have a set with two tracks, a drum loop and some chords. I've loaded an Echo device on the drum loop, which I'm now going to solo so that we can look into Echo properly. Delay lines are set to the left and right channels and can be linked or unlinked to each other. The delay time can sync to the tempo of the set or set the time in milliseconds. By using the input dial, you can set the gain for the dry signal. You can distort the signal with an overdrive to add more character simply by turning the dial beyond 0 dB. If you like more distortion, then you can click the D button. The feedback adjusts the amount of delay signal that is fed back into the delay lines for processing. Turning the feedback dial above 100% creates more extreme feedback settings. Use the feedback with caution above 100% when using headphones or monitor speakers at higher volumes. Delay offset creates tiny shifts in the delay time and can be set independently of each delay line. Changes in the delay time create changes in the visualization known as the echo tunnel. Using the filters, you can filter frequencies of the delayed signal. There is a high pass and a low pass filter. Each of them has a resonance. Adding reverb can create a more spatial effect to your delay signal. The reverb can be controlled with a dial. With a chooser directly under the reverb dial, you can choose where the reverb will be positioned in the signal flow of the echo device. It can be placed after the delay, post, in front of the delay, pre, or within the feedback loop. The decay can also be set. The stereo width can be adjusted to create wide stereo delay or mono delay sounds. The output control allows you to adjust the volume of the device. The dry-wet control creates a balance between the dry signal and the delayed signal. The delay can also be set to stereo, ping-pong, or mid-side.